Okay, let's do this. Gotta get in the groove around here. I don't know what it'll play, I'm just gonna hit the button. The head ready to prime. That took a lot. I was surprised how much this thing fought me. Just, it was a lot more beat up on all the corners than I thought, but it wasn't, I don't know how to describe it. It's like it wasn't so much that it was beat up. It was almost like it was just the roughness of the build. You know, the pieces of wood were a little bit more rounded. That could be just wear and tear. I mean, this thing's coming up on 50 years old now, so that's pretty old for a piece of wood like this. And no big deal, just sharpen everything up, get it where it's worth priming, and then take it from the primer to where it's worth painting. So there's that. All right, there's my lower. I've got the runners in place. I got everything sanded and marked that I need to fill, and this should go pretty well, pretty quick. I might be able to get this stuff primed today if I don't run out of patience for it. It's getting kind of late, but that doesn't bother me. I don't mind that. just put that Globetrotters gameplay video out. You know, that, you know, at the end, that my wife, I just have got my wife back out of the hospital. She had a stroke like 3 days ago, if you can believe that, man. I know it's crazy because here she is playing pinball and waiting on us again and doing everything. But, I mean, it was pretty scary. She couldn't talk at all. And then now her speech is already starting to come back to her. When she first left the hospital about, I guess it's been about 2 days ago now, they were like, oh yeah, she might be able to talk again, and she might never talk again, or it might get better, it might not ever get better. And I could see in her face, she was like, fuck that, I'll be talking. I can see it. And she's already, I mean, you could hear in the video, I mean, she's doing pretty good. She struggles for some of her words here and there. You know, she's not 100%, but I would say she's a good 80 or 90%. And if that's as good as it gets, we'll take that. That's fine. I mean, if it's zero, we don't care. But you know what I'm saying? It's just, I bring that up. I don't really like to put any drama in here. You know what I mean? I don't want that. I hate drama. But I put that in there just because, you know, I guess we all know this, but it's insane how quickly things can change in your world. You just don't know. It's just crazy. But all is well around here as far as that goes. Now we do have to watch her a little bit more. All right, back at it today. Just got this few little spots of Bondo to knock down, and then I'll be ready to prime all this stuff. This right here, just working the seam over. That's pretty much what it is. Just seams and screw holes at this point. And we'll be ready to prime this stuff. If we get it primed early in the day, I might sand it and paint it and clear it later. Or I might just, you know, leave it alone till tomorrow. I don't know, but that's where things are at. Okay, let's go over where things are at real quick. I've got the cabinet ready to prime, and I'm gonna use a 4:1 urethane primer on that, I always do. And then I've got these metal pieces, so this would be the back door for the head and the trim that the back door, the channel that the back door sits in. And I got a couple different ways I can refinish this stuff to make sure that it sticks well to this galvanized metal. I can epoxy prime it. That's extremely slow, but it's very durable, and it's a one-shot deal. You just shoot it with the epoxy primer, and you wait, they say a day, I say 2 days, because it can stay softer than you think. You can do that, and it's a one-shot deal, or you can metal etch it, and then use the same 4:1 primer that I'm gonna use on the cabinet, and achieve basically the same thing. I would say you get a little bit less durability, but not in a way that's going to count for this application. It's the back door of a pinball machine. It's not not the front end of a car. So, so for that reason, the convenience of it primarily and the consistency of it, I'm going to metal etch it and then use the same primer on both. And what that'll do will make it where I can sand this cabinet and these panels anywhere from 4 hours on. So after 4 hours, if I want to sand this, I can and paint it. I don't have to, but it only takes 4 hours for this stuff to dry, and then it can be sanded. So it's a better choice. It won't throw things out of sync like it would if I did one with one type of primer and one with the other type of primer. I would have a timing issue. So I'm gonna go ahead and metal etch this real quick, just the bare metal stuff, and then we will mix up some primer and prime this cabinet. Okay, there it is, primed and guide coated. You know the drill with that. So I'm gonna move this stuff out even though it's not ready to sand yet. I'm gonna move this stuff out and go ahead and get out ahead of cleaning up the room so I can, it'll be ready. It's almost time to change the overspray carpet in here, but not quite. I could probably squeeze one or two more jobs out of here and then I gotta do that. But there's our metal panel, new lower. Reusing the original head and the channel for it. All right. Get that stuff in order. I'm just gonna base it in white, pearl coat it, and clear it. And that's gonna be it for now. Because, like I said, I got some plans for this thing. I had the play field in there too. I'll probably grab that towards the end after I got all this color done. I'll probably pick this up off of here, put it to the side, you know, clear it real quick. It's just a little channel. Put it to the side, and then I'll lay that play field on here, and I'll clear that also at that point. So we'll get suited up and we'll get this done. keeps our cabinet. It's dried overnight. Looks good. All I gotta do with this now is just sand it and stencil it. This back panel, it doesn't really probably need anything. It just depends on what gloss level I choose to go with and if I choose to put any art on the back of it. If I put any art on the back of it, it'll just be something I make up real quick with my stencil cutting machine and just probably a little creativity. Lower, that looks really good. So that's all set. I don't need to get inside of here anymore. I'm done with the inside because it's gonna have a lot of things covered. I just wanna turn it white, pearl white, clear it, and just seal it off. I just strictly focused on the outside on this one, unlike the custom Kiss I did recently and the Globetrotters where I, you know, turned the floor into kind of like an art piece. It's just got an MDF floor, so I don't have to worry about that. And I wouldn't waste my time with a plywood floor or anything like that on this because you're never going to see it with that big EM mechanism down in the floor of it. It's just pointless. So that's the deal with that stuff. I'll figure out what I'm going to get into. I don't know quite what I'm going to do with myself today yet. But once I figure it out, I'll start working towards either getting this cabinet stenciled or something else I got going on around here. We'll see. Okay, I'm just gonna, right here where it sits, I'm gonna knock this down lightly with some 800 and I'll run over it with a Scotch-Brite and blow it off, wipe it down, and I think we'll start thinking about painting it. Well, stenciling it. Okay, here we go. I am going to get this cabinet painted today, I hope. I'll tell you what, I got a couple challenges about it. So I need to paint some silver for a background, but it's got to be in exactly the right spot. It can't get outside of where it needs to be or else it'll show where I don't want it to. And so that's one of the biggest reasons that I went ahead and cleared this just initial base coat with the pearl. That way I can wipe it off if it's not quite right. So we'll see how that goes. And I don't want to make a big sharp line, so I got to kind of figure it out as I go. It's mostly where it's going to say Bally in the back box and Captain Fantastic on the side. So I'll have to cut these stencils and figure that out. And so I'll trim everything up and I'll start doing that and we'll just work. Back. It took me a little while to figure this out. I had to do it privately. I couldn't do it on here. I was trying, but I was just like, I was back and forth, running around, wiping stuff off, mixing up stuff, just, you know, once I get to where I'm trying to figure something out, if it's, especially if it's not going well, I get in like a tailspin. I just work. I don't even think about it until I get it where I want it. So I got it where I want it now. The silver background, that wasn't too hard. It was a little bit to map out. I got a little bit of an edge right here, but I think I'm going to leave that. And if I do leave it, then I'm going to duplicate it on the other side. I can get it off there. It's not the problem, but it almost looks like a carryover, a pinstripe. So I kind of like that. So I might do that on the other side. And silver, no problem. I use this really coarse silver. It almost looks chromatic. So that's pretty cool. The red, I've been struggling with my red. I've been trying to find a candied red that really has some pop, and they almost always look burgundy. And this one looks a little bit burgundy, but not that much. And I'll tell you why. Because this isn't a candy red. What this is a straight bright red. And then I've dusted a fire orange, a tangerine orange candy right over top of that. So it's gonna have a certain look when it gets cleared. Can be hard to tell from right now, but it's really just straight red like I use on the Globetrotters, just a straight red and a dusting of this orange. If you looked at it, you'd be like, damn, that's orange metallic, but it's a fire orange. So dusting that very lightly over top of this straight red gives me that effect, and I think that's gonna work. I've been kind of fighting through that. I fought through it with the Globetrotters, and I thought I got a little bit of a better formulation for this one, and I sprayed that. I was like, nah, that ain't it either. And then I'm like, okay, you know what you have to do. You're on your own, you figure it out. And so I think I've done that. And what I'm gonna try to do with this is get the blue down and kind of complete the head before I mess with the lower. And that way, if this isn't a go, I don't have so much rework ahead of me on the lower. But we'll get into that in just a little bit. Got the blue stencil on. This will be the last stencil for the head. I'll probably have a little touch-up stuff here or there, but we'll see how it goes. I'm trying to get all the way through one thing, and we'll see if it works. Now, normally I would wipe the color stacks off, and I did that prior to this, but man, I'm not going to because I notice it's a little bit, that red that I made, it's so custom, I don't want to take any chances. So I won't wipe the color stacks off for that. And I gotta throw some paper on it. And we'll blast some blue on there. Put you right here. There we go. So this will be ready to clear. Looks really good. Looks really good. So we'll deal with that. I don't know if I'll start working on the lower, if I'll just clear this and walk away from it for today. I might just clear this and walk away from it for today. And then tomorrow I can get into the play field and the lower cabinet together. We'll see. There it is. It's flashed off good enough. I got my flashlight on. I'm going to try to give you a really good vantage point of the color. And we'll get up close and get an idea of what's going on here. So you can see the pearl in good detail with that light shining on it. And now let's check out some of the other colors. It's that blue. It's that red. That silver. So that's what this thing really looks like when you look at it. But it can be hard, I noticed, in these videos and even in photos. So I wanted to really show you that in detail and let you get a better appreciation for what I'm going for here. So So that looks good. We'll let it set overnight and we'll try to do the same thing to the lower and we'll go from there.